各位朋友大家好，今天呢我们在现场特别要跟各位听众访问心域奇迹的作者 Jerry 老师。那另外呢，就是现场因为 Jerry 老师他本身是在讲英文的，那我们今天呢也特别邀请了就是333身心灵的萨丹娜老师担任我们现场的即时口译。那我们现场欢迎两位老师。我们有四个问题想要跟老师询问一下，就是说第一个问题是老师如何发现就是心域奇迹这套治疗技术的呢？
The first question is, how did you find out about star magic, this healing modality?
Do you want the short answer or the detailed answer?
你要短版还是长版的答案？
短版好了。对。
I think the short one is fine.
Okay. So I used to be a criminal.
我以前曾经是一个罪犯。
I used to smuggle drugs and guns.
那我以前走私毒品跟枪支。
And I was very egotistical and driven by money, fast cars.
那我以前非常自大，我的动力都是为了要买跑车啦，买这些物质的东西。
I was very materialistic.
然后我非常的物质主义。
And then a string of events happened.
然后在我生命中发生了一连串的事件。
The first one, I was traveling in a taxi.
第一件事就是我当时在坐计程车。
I was asleep in the passenger seat.
然后我在后座睡着。
And the taxi ran three ladies over.
然后这个计程车撞倒了三位小姐。
The first one came through the windscreen, smashed me in the face, got flipped over the car and died.
第一位小姐，第一位女士呢，她直接冲进这个，就是撞破计程车的挡风玻璃。撞到我，然后这个就死，当场死亡了。
The second lady had her ankles cut clean off.
然后第二个女士她的脚踝就被切掉。
And the third lady was physically okay.
但是第三位女士她的身体没有受伤。
My ex-wife and children were traveling in the car with me.
那我的前妻跟我的小孩当时也在车里面。
But remember, I was asleep, so I didn't really know any of this happened. I only found out afterwards.
但是我当时是睡着的，所以我对这一切是没有意识的。我是后来才发现的。
When the car stopped, I got out of the car and I walked towards what I thought was a dead body.
所以当我这个苏醒的时候呢，我就从车里走出来，然后我到那个尸体，我以为它是一个尸体旁边。
As I got closer and closer, it was the lady that had come through the windscreen.
当我越来越靠近那个女士的身体，也就是那个从挡风玻璃飞进来的那个女士。
And I saw her soul hovering above her body.
然后我看到她的灵魂呢，就在浮在她的身体上方。
And up until this point in my life, I didn't believe in any of this stuff.
那其实在这一刻之前呢，我这一辈子都不相信这种事情。
And this is what kind of really kick-started my spiritual journey.
所以是这一件事呢，开始把我推到灵性的道路。
Then lots of other things happened.
然后还有很多其他的事情发生。
One of the main ones was a trip in a spaceship.
其中一个主要的事件就是我被带到一个太空船上。
I was meditating in my friend's garden in New Zealand with my eyes open.
我当时是张开眼睛在静坐，在我纽西兰朋友的这个后花园里面。
And a little spaceship came and landed in the garden.
然后一个太空船就降落在这个花园里。
There was a blue being inside of it.
然后太空船里有一个蓝色的人。
I went and got inside the spaceship, and we went through a tunnel of light for about 4 seconds.
然后我就进入了这个太空船，然后我们进入一个光的隧道，大概4秒钟。
We came out the other side and we were on another planet.
当我们从隧道出来的时候，我们已经在另外一个星球上。
On that planet, lots of things happened. I met lots of these blue beings.
在那个星球上呢，有很多事情发生，我遇到很多这样蓝色的人。
And I went through an initiation on this planet.
然后我在这个星球上经过某种点化。
I was given this powerful frequency through my crown chakra, which contained geometry, binary information.
所以呢，我就被下载或是被给予透过我的顶轮呢，这种新的或充满几何的这种频率。
And then they brought me back.
然后他们再把我带回来。
About 2 years later, I started seeing all of this stuff that came in the orange download of Light in the Air.
那两年之后呢，我开始在生活中也看见这些，就是在空中也看见这些这个橘色的几何。几何图形。
Then I was guided to Egypt.
然后我又被引导到埃及。
And I spent 9 months in ancient mystery schools.
然后我花了9个月的时间在那个古老的神秘学院。
And whilst I was in the mystery schools, the man that was there teaching me and other people, he was showing us how to heal people using these codes that came into me.
那当我在那个学院里的时候呢，那里的长老他就是教我如何在我顶轮，如何用我顶轮里接收到这些几何图形去疗愈人。
When I was in the mystery schools, they showed me lots of symbols, and one of them meant healing magic.
那当我在那个神秘学院里面，我得到很多的符号，那其中一个就是关于疗愈的魔法。
And that's where the magic part of the name comes from.
那所以这就是为什么星域奇迹就是 star magic 就是有 magic 这个字。
And the star part comes from the trip to the planet in space.
那 star 就是星星这个字，就是因为我去到了这些星球。
After being in the mystery schools for 9 months, people just started coming into my life that needed healing.
在那个神秘学院待了9个月之后呢，生活中就出现各种需要我疗愈的人。
And I started.Practicing with what I'd been taught.
所以我就开始操练我所被教导的。
And everybody that I was working with was getting better. They were getting healed.
然后所有的人他们都就是接受疗愈的人，他们都有好转，都有被疗愈。
So I thought maybe I can start a business.
所以我就想说，也许我可以开始。
And that's when Star Magic was born.
也许我开始可以开始做这个这个工作，这个生意，所以 Star Magic 就。诞生了。
That was the really short version of the story.
所以这是简短版。
OK。
刚才在课程中，我们有体验到，就是说老师有带一个宇宙次元的一个进行冥想的过程。那其实我跟大部分朋友，就是说在做这些冥想的过程中，会进入一个状态，就是说比较容易去睡着。那在关于这一点，就是说老师在演练这些冥想的过程中，有没有办法给我们这些学员一些建议呢？
So, we experienced a very special meditation with you just now, but, me and I think many other people, we tend to fall asleep in meditations, or we cannot see any kind of visual things in meditation. So, for people like us, what do you suggest?
It depends what you're doing this for.
那这是取决于你为什么要做这个静心。
If you're doing these meditations because you want to heal,
如果你做这个静心是因为你要疗愈
，then it's okay to fall asleep.
那睡着是没有关系的。
Because your subconscious mind is still picking up.
因为你的潜意识心头脑还在。
Everything that's happening.
他吸收，他会吸收他听到所有的。
And even though you're asleep, you're still going on the journey.
所以即使你睡着，你其实还是有走上这个旅程。
But you can use meditation for many other things.
但是你可以用静心来做很多其他的事。
One thing I use meditation for is discovering new information.
那比如说，我会用静心来发现新的资讯。
Or remembering old information, which is really the same.
或者是记起古老的资讯，其实他们是同一件事。
So if you're going into a meditation to journey to other galaxies and meet angels or other beings, fairies, extraterrestrials, you need to stay awake.
所以如果你静心是为了跑去其他的次元呢，其他的宇宙去遇见天使啦，那当然你就必须是清醒的。
So you're fully aware of the communication.
所以你才知道你们之间的沟通。
If you're going into a meditation or a meditative state to access these other frequency bands or realms.
但是如果你进入静心是为了去碰触这些接触其他的这种频率的话。 或者是其他的次元。
Then I would suggest doing it first thing in the morning when you're fully awake.、Mm-hmm.
那我会建议你一早睡醒的时候就马上做。
When you're going into a meditation experience, like a guided one like this,
那如果你是做我们刚才这种引导式静心
and you want to stay awake, you've just got to stay focused.
那你就是让必须让自己很清醒，然后是很 focus.
Everybody can do it.
每一个人都可以做。
But what's happening is the energy is taking you, and you're allowing it, which isn't a bad thing.
但是所发生的就是呢。能量它占据了你，等于说你被能量给带着走。其实这不是一件坏事。
Because as I said, sometimes we need to go deep to have the healing.
因为我们有时候要得到疗愈，必须走到很深。
So it's really kind of a matter of choice. You've got to decide why you want to do the meditation in the first place. Do you want to heal? Do you want to go on a journey? Do you want to have an experience? Do you want to meet beings?Because obviously some you want to stay awake for and some you don't.
所以呢，取决于你是为了什么目的做静心，你是想要疗愈呢，还是想要去遇见其他次元的生命啊？当然，有一些生命可能是你不想遇见的，可是有一些是你想遇见的。
But it really comes down to discipline.
但基本上重点是在纪律。
And practice.
还有练习。
But ultimately, you've just got to decide what it is you want to get out of it.
但基本上最终你还是要去决定你想要从静心中得到什么。
But it's so easy to fall asleep in a meditation if you're just going with the flow and the energy's taking you.
那其实在静心中让能量带走睡着是很容易。
The reason I say do it in the morning is because a lot of people on this planet are too tired.
那为什么我说在一早就是早上做是因为我们地球上很多人都非常的疲倦。
Most people, as soon as they shut down and they go into a quiet space, they fall asleep.
所以大部分人呢，就是他一旦有一个安静的空间，他就睡着。
Because they very rarely give themselves that space.
因为他们很少给自己这样的空间时间。
But if you do it first thing in the morning, when you're fully awake, it's going to be easier for you to practice.
但是如果你每天早上起来，然后已经清醒的时候做这个。
There's no right or wrong way to meditate.
就很好，所以静心没有什么对或错的方式。
Meditation can be done whilst you're driving your car, whilst you're writing a book, whilst you're at work, whilst you're in the office. It can be done everywhere.
其实静心可以是随时随地的，甚至当你在开车、当你在擦地板、当你在写书的时候都可以。
True meditation is just stillness of the mind.
真正的静心是。头脑的静止
No thoughts, no pictures, no images.
头脑的极静，也就是当你没有任何的念头啦，或是画面啦。
So it all depends really what you're trying to get out of it, what you class as meditation.
所以取决于你想要从这个静心中得到什么。
Everybody's individual experience is unique.
每一个人的经验都是独特的。
最后一个问题呢，我想要帮我一个朋友问，就是说他家人现在面临就是一个就是癌症或者是一个生死关头的过程。我刚刚在会场上有看到老师的疗愈手非常的厉害，就是似乎可以就是诊治非常多的一个疾病，但是现在如果说对于我朋友他如果说面临临终这一关的话，就是说他究竟是要来参加老师的疗愈手的一个课程呢，还是也是应该要去进行医疗的这个部分呢？我想要跟老师询问一下老师个人对这样子的一个看法。
Absolutely. I mean, people come to the workshop for different reasons. Some people come because they want to learn how to heal other people. They want to improve their energy healing business.
他可以来，因为有些很多人是为了不同的原因来上工作坊。有些人想要疗愈别人，有些人要疗愈自己，有些人想要成为疗愈师。
Other people come to the workshop because they want to heal themselves.
那当然也有想要疗愈自己的人。
Whether you want to heal yourself or learn to heal other people, you're going to get both.
不管你是想要疗愈别人还是疗愈自己，你两者都可以都会学到。
The training environment is such an intense, energetic space that you can't help but heal.
所以我们那个 training 那个工作坊的空间是一个非常有强烈能量的一个空间，所以你一定会被疗愈。
You're submerged in the frequency for 5 days.
因为你五天都在那个能量场里。
So if your friend has cancer, I highly recommend they come.
所以如果你朋友有癌症的话，我强烈建议他来。
What's also important to mention is that the body is a highly advanced communication device.
那也值得一提的就是，身体其实是一个非常先进的一个沟通工具。
When we have illness, injury, disease, the body is just saying to us, "Hey, you need to look in this particular area."
当我们有各式各样的疾病的时候，就是身体在告诉我们说，哎，你应该要注意这个部分。
But what happens at school? We're not taught how to read the body.
但是在学校中，我们并没有被教导如何要去，如何去读身体。
So we think that something bad is wrong.
所以我们以为那是一个不好的事情。
So we go to the doctors, expecting them to give us some pills and fix it.
然后我们就去看医生，然后期待他给我们一些药丸。
But the body can self-heal.
来治好身体，但是身体它可以疗愈自己。
Cancer is no worse than a headache.
其实癌症并不是比头痛更严重。
It's just a different method of communication.
它只是另外一种沟通方法。
The cancer, the tumor is just a symptom.
癌症那个肿瘤它是一个症状。
The headache is a symptom.
头痛也是。
The broken arm is a symptom.
手臂断掉也是。
What we need to do is to find the cause and eliminate it.
所以我们需要发现它的根源，然后去排除它。
Once we do that, the disease clears up straight away.
那一旦我们这么做，这个疾病就会被疗愈了。
And we show people a number of different ways to do it on our training.
那我们在这个工作坊里会介绍很多种方法给大家去做。
So if any healers are listening to this, come to the training. If any people that are sick are listening to this, come to the training.
所以如果你是疗愈师，你就来上我们的工作坊。如果你是现在有任何疾病，
也欢迎
你来。
You're going to transform in so many ways.
你会在很多种的方式被转化。
Thank you.